Hello, I'm Behnam Jafari and welcome to the PicoBit-Tech channel. Today, we'll be walking through the installation of ESP-IDF on Eclipse. This method is recommended by Espressif for setting up ESP-IDF. Before we begin, ensure that the ESP-IDF plugin is already installed on Eclipse. Additionally, you need to have the following software installed on your system: MinGW Git, Python, and JDK. Here is the recommended installation order. First, start by installing MinGW using system. Next, install Git. Then, install JDK and Python. Finally, install the ESP-IDF plugin. It's important to note that ESP-IDF plugin and ESP-IDF itself are two separate components, and both must be installed on your system for Eclipse to work correctly with ESP-IDF. For a more detailed explanation of these prerequisites, you can check out our videos link at the top of this screen. If you're ready, let's go. First, open your browser and go to the ESP-IDF repository on GitHub. A link to the repository is provided in the video description. At the time of creating this video, the latest version of ESP-IDF is 5.4, which was recently released and is available for installation. You can download it here. However, in this tutorial, we will focus on version 5.3. You can find the zip file for version 5.3 in the assets section. Download the file, extract it, and keep it ready for the next step. Next, launch Eclipse. On the startup screen, you'll see the workspace path. You can leave it as is and click launch to press it to the main window. From the Espressif menu, select Add ESP-IDF and then choose Use an existing ESP-IDF directory. Click Browse. Navigate to the folder where you extracted the ESP-IDF files and select it. Sometimes the ESP-IDF version automatically downloaded by Eclipse may cause errors. If this happens, delete defaulty version and replace it with the one you downloaded from the GitHub repository. You'll also need Git and Python for the installation. The links to their installation guidance are provided at the top of the screen. It's recommended to use the default installation path for these tools. Once the replacement is complete, reopen Eclipse. And go to the Add ESP-IDF again. Select Use an existing ESP-IDF directory and use the Browse button to locate the ESP-IDF folder. Double check the paths for Git and Python to ensure they are correct. You'll also see the ESP-IDF version display in the dialog box. Click Finish to complete the setup. After installation, the ESP-IDF version will appear in the ESP-IDF manager. To test if everything is working, go to the File menu, choose New and then Project. In the visor, select Espressif IDF project and click Finish. Select Create a project using one of the templates and choose the Hello World template. Click Finish to create the project. Open the project folder, double click the main C file and view the code. If Eclipse shows unrecognized code, this issue will be resolved during the build and compile process, as Eclipse will automatically download the necessary dependencies using Git. Thank you for watching. To stay updated with our upcoming videos, click on our logo and subscribe to the channel, a video series covering the prerequisite for installing ESP-IDF is available in the playlist linked above.